In this video, I'm going to show you this Timeusb Pro battery. If it stands up to my testing, it could be the best budget-friendly quality lithium iron phosphate 12-volt battery I've seen. Okay, let's quickly talk about what come in the box. It of course, come with a product manual. I've looked through this already. Very good information. I'll put some screenshots of things in here a little bit later. It has a beginner operation guide, which is very useful if you're just starting out to kind of give you some tips on how to hook these things up. And of course, stickers. It has one set of M8 terminal studs here with little washers and protective caps. Here's the battery itself. So we have a removable nylon strap, which is very common. We have on the terminals here, we have a little protective caps for like shipping and storage to keep things from touching both sides, metallic object touching both sides. We have a epoxied in terminals, red, and it says positive on the terminal, so that's clearly marked negative and positive. And let's look at the outside of the battery here. So we have, look at this little guy here. He's like some kind of superhero or electron or something. I don't know, I'm not sure. He's got boxing gloves and a mask. And on this side, you can see a B on his chest. And I guess that stands for battery. I looked on the website to see if I could find what this was, but I couldn't figure out what he is supposed to be. So I'm going to be doing some testing later, and coming up I'm going to charge this up and be doing some testing, and stick around. I'm going to run my garage refrigerator with this battery and we'll see how that goes along with some other testing. So before I charge this battery up and start the testing, I want to check the voltage on this battery. So why would I check the voltage? So the voltage should be between 13.1 and 13.2. And so what does that have to do with anything? The reason is that we check that is because we want to ensure that, of course, that the battery works, and that the battery was stored at a recommended 50% state of charge. It is recommended that batteries for storing for any period of time should be done at 50% state of charge to help ensure the long battery life. There's no state of charge reading on this battery, so the only way to do is to estimate it by measuring the voltage. So we're checking the voltage here, and as you can see, it is coming in at 13.13, and that is perfect. So the Timeusb battery is all fully charged now. And I was going to run a capacity test, but I've decided first I'm going to do a refrigerator test with my DIY solar generator I put together. I've kind of customized this just for this test. I have this 3000 watt inverter. My next video will be coming out. I'm going to do a review on this. I have this part of this test here. Now let me point out for people, if you don't know, this is a 3000 watt inverter. That can draw a whole lot more than this battery can handle. So this is just a test, and I'm not going to be drawing anywhere near the capacity of 3,000 watts that inverter can handle. So I think you should probably have three of these batteries wired in parallel in order for the capacity of this inverter, 3,000 watts. So let me start here. I don't have to do this. I have a battery switch, and I can just leave this off and hook this up. But I'm going to just for kicks and show you that if you didn't have this battery switch, and had it turned on, in order to not have a spark when you hook it up to the battery, you use a little resistor here. And if I just put it on right now, it would spark. So to avoid that spark, you touch the resistor to the hot wire here. And if you notice, I don't know if you saw that, but the light came on over here. Okay, it got some power. Now I can hook this up, and it shouldn't. It didn't spark, as you saw. Now I'm fully hooked up. I'll tighten those down in just a minute, and we are ready to test. Okay, so the battery terminals have all tightened up. We're ready to go. There's no solar coming in at all right now. It's the solar charge controller disconnected from the battery. I just turned on the inverter and plugged in the refrigerator. And we are now off and running with this Timeusb battery and this 3000 watt inverter, which I mentioned earlier is too big for the battery, but this is just a test. I won't be pulling too much. It's not drawing anything right now because the battery is cold. It is 4:27 p.m. Central Time, and it is 77 degrees in the garage. So I'll check in occasionally and see how this battery holds up powering this refrigerator. It's 6:25 a.m. the next morning. It is 71 degrees in the garage. and the refrigerator's running fine. By the way, this is about a 25 cubic foot refrigerator. Temperature of the garage makes a huge difference in how long the battery can run this. So we're down to 12.89 volts on the battery. I'm guessing maybe 25% of the battery is remaining. This test is more about how long will it run my refrigerator than actual capacity of the battery. So up next, after this test is complete, I'll be running an actual capacity test. Stay tuned. Okay, it is 10:33 a.m. later in the morning, and I was just out here 30 minutes ago and everything was fine, but now the inverter is complaining about low voltage and we're at 11.06 volts. So I'm going to call this and turn off the inverter. Okay, so that refrigerator test lasted for about 18 hours. So you're able to run a refrigerator with this Timeusb battery for 18 hours, at least my refrigerator. It's a full-size refrigerator, around 25 cubic feet, I believe. And it's about 12 years old, so it's not the newest refrigerator or the most energy efficient. And of course, temperature in the garage was between 71 and 77. That's pretty good. I ran a refrigerator test that was about 90 degrees in here when I was testing the Blue Eddy power station out, and that didn't last very long because of that. So I've now hooked in solar. I have 400 watts, two 200 panels outside, and it's bouncing around because it's partly cloudy, but I'm bringing in about 24, 25 amps right now. So hopefully this battery will get charged up for the capacity test. Okay, so the battery's all charged up. I just turned on the battery capacity test, and it looks like I'm pulling in about 12.5 amps, 160 watts. So once the results are done, I'll come back and let you know what they were. I'll do a quick check-in, see how we're doing. I bumped up the amps a little bit, so this will go a little faster. Looks like we're at almost 95 amp hours and 1184 watt hours. So I'll check back in here in just a minute when we finish. So the battery test is complete in almost exactly 8 hours. And as you can see there, we have just under 102 amp hours, which is over their stated capacity, but slightly under on watt hours. I'm not really sure the reason for that. So we have 1,262 versus 1,280 they advertised. So that's almost the capacity, so that's not enough to worry me. I would feel fine with that. So capacity test passed. Okay, we're getting ready to start the load test. Timeusb battery is hooked into this DIY solar generator I built. We have an oil heater on the floor. We have a heat gun, and they're both plugged into the back of the inverter. And I'm going to start the test, and we're going to run this for 10 minutes and keep an eye on the amps. And we're going to try to stay right at 100 amps. Close as I can get it, maybe slightly above. Let's get started. Here's the oil heater. Touch this to make sure it don't time out on me. And as you can see, we're pulling 60 amps right now. And then we'll kick on the heat gun. I've already got it set to where I think it needs to be. So we're right at, 100 amps. Let's hit start there, 100.5. And we'll come back after 10 minutes and make sure everything works good. Okay, so we handled that no problem. 100 amps for 10 minutes, no problem at all. Let's check the battery here and just take a quick little feel of it, make sure nothing's hot. It feels totally normal to the touch. Not that they were testing the wires here, but the wires are just barely warm. Those are 1-aught wires there. Okay, so the last test was the 100 amp test. That worked fine. So this time I'm going to throw the full force of the oil heater, which has two elements. I only ran one last time, and the heat gun, and let's see what we get up to here. And I'm not going to run this as long as it goes. I'm going to cut it off if it goes a minute. Up to 120 amps. Turn on the heat gun. Up to a little over 200 amps here. Let's see if we can go a minute like this. I hear something beeping. Looks like the inverter is complaining. It's probably up around its limit. Let's zoom in here and see. Yeah. 200 amps. I'm just going to go ahead and crank up the heat gun to full blast and let's see what happens here. Okay, 230 amps, 232 amps. It's really beeping now. It may be that the inverter turns us off, even though it's a 3,000 watt inverter. Okay, we've been going. We went a full minute there. The inverter's cooling off, fans are running. But we did go a full minute while at 230, I think I saw 232 amps there. And I'm gonna call this test complete. So my testing went very well. Even though I did not push this battery until the BMS shut us down, I did show that you can draw over 200 amps for at least a minute. The manual says you can go up to 280 amps for 5 seconds. Of course, in a real-world situation, you would not want to be pushing a battery anywhere near that hard. It will definitely stress it out and reduce the lifespan of the battery. I decided to not open this battery up. I will put a link in the description below where another YouTuber opened up this exact same battery. He did a much better review of the internal components than I could have. He finds that the internal build quality and the cells are excellent quality. So, what is this Group 31 battery good for? As you know, we focus on emergency preparedness on this channel, and of course, it would be perfect for that. You can connect these batteries in series or parallel for up to 16 batteries, which results in a whopping 20 kilowatt hours of storage. You can also use the 4S4P configuration as shown here. One of the things to point out is that this battery does not have low temperature protection or self-heating, so you can't charge it in sub-freezing conditions, but you can use it in freezing conditions, but you just can't charge it. You can also use this battery for many other things like RVing, boating, fishing, camping, off-grid cabin, and many other uses where you need a deep cycle battery. This battery is not designed for starting, though. It can't use it for that. This battery is safe. It uses only grade A prismatic cells. The BMS has protections also, such as overcharge protection, over-discharge protection, overcurrent protections, short circuit protection, and high temp cutoff protection. And this battery will last you for a very long time. It has a 100% depth of discharge for over 4,000 cycles. Now, if you're new to battery review such as this and you aren't familiar with the term depth of discharge, this means you can discharge this battery from 100% state of charge down to zero, charge it back up to a full charge again without losing any capacity. Even after 15,000 cycles, you still have 60% of this battery capacity left. That's 43 years, and within 60% of this battery left. That's crazy. That's one of the benefits of lithium iron phosphate. If I didn't cover every specification of this battery in this review, here's a quick look at the main parameters of the batteries from the manual. You can pause the video and take a closer look. So what are my final thoughts on this battery? Well, as I thought it might be, all indications are this is a high-quality battery at an excellent price. It performed very well on my testing, and the other YouTuber that tore it down found that it's a high-quality internal build as well. And Timeusb backs this battery up with a 5-year warranty. Also, from what I could tell from searching different sites and reviews and looking at a lot of people's comments, it seems that the Timeusb customer service is good. even though I didn't have to contact them myself, so I have no experience myself. I would definitely recommend this battery. At the time I'm filming this video, the price on this battery is $209 on Timeusb's website. They have a coupon code on their site which brings it down to $198. But I have a link and a discount code below that will save you 6% on this battery and everything else on Timeusb website. That 6% discount will bring this battery all the way down to $196. So if you're in the market for a battery like this, a high quality lithium iron phosphate 12-volt 1.5-hour battery for under $200 is a crazy good price. Sure, there's other high quality batteries out there, but I don't think there's one out there that can beat this price currently. Well, I hope you really enjoyed this video review. Remember, I have a review on that inverter I used in the testing coming up very soon. And I have some other interesting things coming up very soon. So I really appreciate it if you made it to the end of this video. That really helps my channel out a lot. Thank you very much for watching.